3, I mean chapter 3, and I want to please work that out. That's going to just disturb me to no end. Do I need to back off of the mind? Do these minds need to be turned off? Okay. I'm in the Bible. I'm reading from Ezra chapter 3 and verse 10. If you have it, say amen.
Amen.
The Bible says this, and when the builders laid the foundation of the temple of the Lord, they set the priests. Who did they set?
Priests.
They set the priests in their apparel with trumpets. And the Levites, the sons of Asaph, with cymbals. With what, everyone?
Cymbals.
We got priests with trumpets and cymbals in the Bible. Why did they set them this way? To praise the Lord. That's what the Bible says. I wish you were looking at your Bible. Look at your Bible. Make sure you're looking at your Bible. I don't want you to think I'm doing anything funny here, that I got some other thing in my head that I'm memorized and I'm just trying to push it on you. I want you to see this is in your Bible. To praise the Lord after the ordinance of David, king of Israel. And they sang together by chorus. Watch this. In praising and giving thanks unto the Lord. Why? Because he is good and his mercy endureth forever. And all the people, hold on to your seats. And all the people shouted. They did what, everyone? Am I reading the Bible? Are you sure I'm reading the Bible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, because the Bible says that all the people shouted with a great shout when they praised the Lord. And they sang together, Ezra chapter 3 and verse 11, and they sang together by chorus, I'm reading that again on purpose, and they sang together by chorus in praising and giving thanks unto the Lord, because he is good, for his mercy endures forever toward Israel. And all the people, and all the people shouted with a great shout when they praised the Lord, because the foundation of the house of the Lord was laid. This is restoration. Some things that have been broken down, some things that have been taken away, God is now restoring them, and because he's restoring them, the people decided what they wanted to do was not sit quietly. They wanted to shout with a loud shout. I'm a shouting preacher. I've been restored. But the text doesn't stop there, because you would think that it was only the young people misbehaving like this. But many of the priests, the what, everyone? Do you have that up there? But many of the priests and the Levites, the chief of the fathers, who were what, everyone? So these are old folks who had a praise too.
It's Bible.
I'm just Bible,
amen?
He was just hoping it's coming from somewhere else, like the Book of Mormon. No, this coming from the Bible. But many of the priests and Levites and chief of the fathers, who were ancient men that had seen the first house when the foundation of this house was laid before, their eyes they wept with a loud voice.
Yes,
and many shouted quietly with joy. Oh, you are reading the same book I'm reading. They shouted aloud for joy, watch this, so that the people could not discern the noise of the shout of joy from the noise of the weeping of the people, for the people shouted with a loud shout, and the noise was heard afar off. I don't know what the name of that street is right there, but when you praise God, people should be able to hear you from afar off and come inside and say, what's going on in this place. And somebody should be turning these mics off, please. I'm a Roman preacher. I'm not going to say it here. Listen, and somebody should walk in and wonder, why are you shouting like that? And you should be able to tell them, I'm shouting because of the goodness of God, for his mercy enduring forever. I'm not shouting because I'm crazy. I'm not shouting because I'm irreverent. I'm shouting because I got joy. Out all sorts of other times. I was reading in the spirit of prophecy because I know you might not believe Brother White. She said some things that were interesting to me. And sometimes I have to catch myself, Elder Alfred, from being a selective keeper. You know, I see certain things in Elder White and I run with it. But then I skip over those other things that she says. And seeing as how we're in mixed company, I'll just leave that alone. If you want to talk to me about it, see me afterwards. We're in Acts chapter 19. Turn from your Bibles to Acts chapter 19. That was just something that was on my heart. We're in Acts chapter 19. When you have it, why don't you say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Some of you don't know, but Hennessy and I, since Genesis and I were talking, Genesis, Carlos, and Angelique and I were talking, and I was telling them that I'm big on fashion. I like to dress nice. I do. I'm not ashamed. But see, the reason why I'm not ashamed that I have as many suits as I do is because I buy them from the secondhand store. I buy 100% virgin wool suits from the secondhand store at about $15-$20. So I can see some of you, even the most conservative in here, you may have paid about $200 for your suit. That's poor stewardship, maybe. I got 10 suits for that amount of money. So I go somewhere and I'm dressed nice. Hallelujah. And so people come up to me and they say things like, Pastor, where did you get your suit from? And then I tell them, well, I got this suit from the secondhand store. And they don't believe me. They don't believe that I bought my suit from the secondhand store. And I say, well, sure I did. You know, you can get some good things at the secondhand store. You can get a nice suit. I wish I had a witness in this place. You can get a nice suit at the secondhand store. You can get a nice tie even or a shirt at the secondhand store. You can get some nice end tables or a mirror at the secondhand store. But there are some things you just don't want to get at the secondhand store. I don't care how desperate I am, I'm just not going to buy underwear, come on somebody, from the secondhand store. I don't care how many times they may have dipped in bleach, I'm just not going to buy a toothbrush. I wish I had a witness in this place. I'm not going to buy a toothbrush from the secondhand store. There are some things you can get and they are useful secondhand, but other things just will not do secondhand. So if you don't mind, for the next few moments, I'll speak to you from the title, Secondhand. We're praying, Church Father. Oh, Lord, we need Jesus. All we have the truth. We got the truth, but we don't have Jesus. And so, Father, I ask that as I stand here as your instrument, that you would speak through me, but please speak to me. I ask, Father, that when we leave this place, that your name would have been glorified, the people of God would have been edified, and the devil would be horrified. For we ask it in Jesus' name, and everyone that agrees, say,
amen.
Our text begins in Acts chapter 19. In Acts chapter 19, the beautiful thing about it, when you're reading, starts with, and it came, watch this, and it came to pass. Can I just park here parenthetically for a moment and mention some things to you that came to pass? You know that bill that's overdue? Sister, it came to pass. You know that man who's no good? He came to pass. You know that bad diagnosis you got from your doctor? It came to pass. You know, it's so many things that we get all hung up over, but if you just read the Bible, you realize that most of those things have only come to pass